The indefinite closures of all schools has been a great worry on learners and parents. After 6 months of the shutdown, the learning institution has been to curb the massive spread of the novel virus.
Because I know school, we know that we are attending school on media and on radios. And as we know, in the world, parents are not the same. Some parents doesn't have radios, doesn't have television. And now some are accessing education and some are not accessing their education.
So that when we are at home, most students don't have that much time of concentrating on their books. Take for instance girls. Girls, they don't have much time of revising in the school, but when they are at home, kitchen became their classroom, cooking utensils became their scholastic material, but today the schools are reopened.
When did the government reopen the school become the regular question. The learners describe how they stayed at home, expose them to unwanted practice, including forced marriage and child labor.
Opening of school is actually good for us to go back because most of the ladies, they have been pregnant, so the solution, they have to come back to school because school is the best. Because if we continue staying at home, most the school ladies, they will get pregnant all and they will go to the house. So we have to come back to school.
So the most challenge that faces girls during the COVID-19 drop out of girls, like for example, pregnancy, and most of the people begin to confuse the girls that...
The partial reopening has been celebrated news from the finalists after the government and education partners launched Go Back to School campaign on 5th October in Juba.
I'm too excited because I should thank the Ministry of Education and the government for the reopening of schools. I'm too excited about this.
That the school are going to commence and everything will be on well. We never thought that the school could be open up this year. We thought that maybe since the year is almost ending to month or another year, we thought that the school could just be ending. And now I'm very happy. My heartfelt goes to the Ministry of Education, plus the elders who decided to open up the school. And I'm feeling pity also to my colleagues, like some age mates of mine who dropped out from school. I really feel pity for them because it might be a result whereby they thought that the school couldn't be opened up and this corona couldn't end. But unfortunately, God has really looked at us.
In my first place, I would like to thank the Minister of General Education because he has done for us a lot. They has opened for us the schools because nowadays sitting just alone at home without doing anything.
The bell ringing occasion was presided by the Vice President for Service Cluster Hussein Abdelbaghi Akol, Awud Deng Ashwil, and other government dignitary, members of diplomatic corps and international NGOs representative. The Minister of General Education and Instruction, Awud Deng Ashwil, expressed willingness of our ministry in providing the COVID-19 preventive kits to ensure the safety of the learners.
I urge the teachers to double their efforts to complete the syllabus so that the pupils successfully sit their examination at the end of the extended academic year.
The Vice President Hussein Abdelbaghi Akol said his administration would prioritize improvement of education section as the government undertake increasement of the salaries for the public teachers.
For the teachers, I want to say 5th October 2020 incidentally marked the World Teacher Days. It is the day the world reflect on the important role teachers play in the society. Teachers have a labor role to play in the preparation of the children, not only for teaching, learning, or examination, but is have a good role to prepare them for a good life and the future for all. These children are the future and hope of our country. We therefore commit ourselves to support the teacher during this difficult period. In my cluster, the service deliver cluster, the education and the health are two backbone of our cluster. And we have to fight very hard That's our priority, to help the teachers, especially to prepare their salaries. And that salaries, the new hierarchy of salaries, we have to fight.
The Ministry of General Education said COVID-19 outbreak has interrupted more than 10 million learners from their studies.
We will continue the distance learning program, delivering lessons on radio and TV. I am pleased to inform you that with assistance from USAID, UNICEF has procured 32,000 radio sets that will be distributed to remote areas across the country to enable the children to follow the lessons on the radio.
We are reopening the school today, but it is important to remember that from the outset, COVID-19 has not disappeared.
But the student and pupil are encouraged to continue tuning to on-air learning program from the designated media platform.